it's Miki. Welcome back to the Neo Nails channel. Today we're going to be doing a luminous design, which means, well, it glows in the dark. And we're going to do moons and stars, kind of like when you were a kid and you had those moons and stars stickers on the ceiling of your bedroom. I bet you had them, didn't you, Adam?
What do you mean when you were a kid? I still have them.
So yeah, it's kind of inspired by that. You could use this technique to do anything that's kind of luminous. So yeah, we'll get cracking. This is one of the new sanding blocks that Neo Nails, because of centres, obviously. They send us all their kind of new stuff. So this is one of their sanding blocks. It's just got their logo on. So what I'm going to do is, on these practice tips, I'm just going to take off the surface shine, because Acrygel does not like shiny surfaces. So if you were doing this on a tip and overlay kind of application, so you've put your tip on the end and you want to put the Acrygel over the top, make sure that your tip is abrased as well. Don't leave your tip shiny. So I'm going to use the Urban Graffiti base coat. Those of you that don't know, Urban Graffiti gel polish system is made by Neo Nails. I know some people might think, oh, well, it just says Urban Graffiti. Does that mean it's somebody else's products? But obviously, here on the Neo Nails channel, we use everything that's Neo Nails. So yeah, the Urban Graffiti is made by Neo Nails, which, can I just add, is not my brand. People think that I own Neo Nails. That's not true. I wish. So we pop them in the lamp, give them a cure. So we're going to pop them in, make sure they're nice and cured, and then this is what we're going to use. So this is the Acrygel. It's the luminous Acrygel, so it obviously glows in the dark. So I was going to use the orange, but I'm not going to use the orange now. I'm actually going to use the blue and the yellow. So we have glow stick and we have Blue Lagoon. We're going to use those two. So this is nice and cured. So with the Acrygel, you literally squeeze it out of the bottle. You can squeeze it directly onto the nail, or you can squeeze it out onto a spatula. So this is not just for colour. This will actually build strength. I'm going to use the Neo Nails gel brush. And I'll need a dampened dish with some gel residue.
You've got an Isaac filming with your hair.
I know, I did notice that. So we've got some gel residue wipe off solution in a dampened dish.
Yeah.
Adam's son is currently sat in Adam's chair.
Say hello.
Hello.
Hello. Are you going to be my director today?
Say hello, YouTube.
Hello, YouTube.
Oh,
we're at Unitoto. Okay.
See you later, okay. Isaac.
Say goodbye.
Bye. bless him.
Oh well, there's my job gone. There's my job gone. He can have that now, obviously.
That's it. Now Isaac is after his dad's job. So we're going to use the gel residue wipe off solution. God, that is such a mouthful. To glide over the product with the brush, so the brush won't stick. And that's because of the gel residue wipe off solution. So I'm just going to sort that free edge out there. Then I'm going to glide this all the way over the nail so we have a nice coverage. So like I said before, not only is this giving colour, it is also creating structure. So this will give you strength. So don't think you need to like put this over the top of acrylic or anything like that. Don't need to do that. This is there for structure and colour. Yeah, I looked up and I was like, oh, we've got Isaac. He's got the headphones on. He's looking like he's knowing what he knows what he's doing.
He does, yeah.
Yeah.
He had such a look on his face as well. He was so happy. Yeah. Oh. I wish the webcam had been recording.
Oh, he could have put him on.
He absolutely loves film production. That's like his favourite thing. So from being probably around about 4 or 5, he's always watched the behind the scenes.
Yeah.
In films. Mm-hmm. And so he spends a lot of time on like YouTube looking at the behind the scenes stuff, like storyboards.
Yeah.
And stuff like that. And then obviously he recreates a lot of his things that he loves. Mm-hmm. I mean, I walked into my kitchen one day and like there was just probably about 150 post-it notes on the floor, and he'd recreated the stampede scene from Lion King.
Yes. And he got all the animals.
Film that I just made.
Say again.
He also helped me on the film I've just made. He came and said action and cut on a couple of scenes.
Oh. I bet he loved that.
He did.
So this time I've showed you a different way. So I squeezed it directly onto the nail. And you see there, you know, either way works. It's entirely up to you what you find best for you. When we're patting and pressing the product, what you need to take into consideration is, I don't know what that is, we have a little piece of something there. What you need to take into consideration when you're using the gel residue wipe off solution on the brush is you want to make minimal contact with the skin. So the brush, you want to make sure that it doesn't touch the skin, because we don't want to dry out the client's skin with the gel residue wipe off solution. And the beautiful thing about Aquagel is you can shape it as nice as you can, so it kind of reduces the filing time. You've got loads of time to do this. It's not going to set until it goes in the lamp. So we're going to wipe the sticky layer off the top. It doesn't have a massive, like, heavy sticky layer. It does have a sticky layer. That needs to be removed with the gel residue wipe-off solution and a lint-free pad. So now we're going to file. I'm going to use a 240 grit file because, it's, you know, the shape isn't too bad. It won't need a massive amount of shaping. Plus, it'll create a nice smooth surface, and Aquagel is nice and easy to file. It's quite soft. And if you're new to the nail industry and you've had a go with acrylic or like even hard gel and you struggle, have a go with Aquagel. You may just find that will work a little bit better for you, and then it'll kind of build you up to then using acrylic. So I'm going to use the buffer to smooth over the nails as well, just to give them a nice smooth finish. So we have Serious Black. You will need nail art brushes for this next part. So we're going to be using the Neo Nail brush, which is 0002. And what we're going to do is, you're going to sketch out
eyebrows.
No, not eyebrows. Not today. Sketch out your moon. Now, talking about moons, I have been fascinated by space just lately. I didn't realize that until I watched lots of Netflix stuff. That so many people had died sort of trying to get to space. So many
have you been watching on Netflix?
So I watched Challenger, The Last Flight.
Yeah.
Oh my God, I was so intrigued by every aspect of the whole documentary. I absolutely loved watching it. And I kind of took a step back and went, oh my God, I'm a geek. I've turned into a geek. I loved it. It was, I just can't, you know, I couldn't believe that something like that was televised, you know, throughout America, and such a tragic event happened live on television.
Yeah.
It was, and I didn't know about it. I kind of had a bit of a thing where I was like, did I know about it? But I forgot.
Two of the people weren't even astronauts, were they? There was two teachers.
No, one teacher there was. There was a lady, there was a teacher, and she was going to be teaching two classes from space. And it was really exciting, you know, the whole thing was, it was so exciting. I just need to flash cure that. It was so exciting, and it was that exciting that I was watching it while I was messing around with nails, and Vanessa was just listening to it, and she was like, oh my God, that's like crazy. Vanessa loved it as well. So yeah, it was pretty cool. I then went on to watch other documentaries about space. I think I'm secretly trying to prove to my dad that the world is not flat. Because, yeah.
Oh, bless him.
Because we know what is true.
Are you sure he just doesn't say that to wind you up?
No, he actually believes it.
I don't believe you. He can't.
He actually believes that the world is flat. I don't know how. He needs to watch these NASA documentaries.
The thing is, these people who believe the world is flat, there's nothing he can do to change their minds.
Oh, no, he's fully been manipulated and by these programs he's been watching. And I'm sure we're going to have other people now commenting, going, oh, the world is flat, it is flat. You know, there'll be flat earthers everywhere telling us that I'm wrong and my dad's right. Can we not tell me that my dad's right? Because, you know, we don't like that. I don't like my dad being right all the time. So now we're just going to do some stars. And I want to do, like, different shaped stars, not just, like, your normal five-pointed star. But lots of things that my dad has said to me about the world being flat, I've already got a answer to them. When we have that conversation again, I will be able to challenge him on his theories because of what I've learned by watching these documentaries.
Good on you.
So, I just don't get why people would think it's flat. What are they getting out of telling us that the world is round? My dad says it's control. And I'm like, but I still don't get why that's...
That's because...
A thing.
That's because you think rationally.
Yeah.
Well, sometimes.
I'm just going to flash cure that. And the point I want to make as well is, don't worry about your edges not being neat, because those edges will not be seen. They will not be seen at all. Now I'm going to do some stars on here as well. Get a little moon on here as well. Clean that up, because I have just touched that. I just want to do this bit here as if this is like kind of like a shooting star. And what you want to do is like work with the gel that you've placed down. So you'll get a sort of little bead on the end of your brush, and then just move that around with your brush into the shape that you want it. So once you've got your little elements of your stars and moons on there, what we're going to do now, and this is the easier part, we're going to put two coats of Serious Black into all of the gaps. So that will block out the fluorescentness, if that is a word. And then the parts that we leave open will glow. So we kind of end up with this. That's one coat, and we'll go over that again. We're going to do exactly the same on the blue, and already I can see how that's going to look in the lamp, and I'm like, ah! Excited.
Stop teasing people.
Oh, it looks so cool. But you can use this.
So you have to do two coats of the black.
Yeah, two coats of the black. To you know, to block out the luminous. But you can, you know, you could use this technique to do you know, like when you do like a neon kind of sign effect. You know, there are other ways that you can use this technique, which is quite cool. You know, I'd like to have a go at lots of different things, really.
I suppose nobody like it. Yeah, sorry, when you do it like this, you can change up the design as much as possible, as much as you want.
Yeah.
Because you're just going to take the gel polish off, but you've still got the colour underneath, haven't you?
Yeah. So when they come back for their infills, they still have their gorgeous sort of glow-in-the-dark nails. So, yeah, you could then, they could even just have them glow-in-the-dark again if they wanted, and you could just put some, you know, your normal kind of nail art. I say normal, I just mean, you know, not that we do normal nail art, everything's a little bit extreme. But yeah, you could do anything then. You could do some one stroke on there. You could just add a bit of bling. It does give it a little bit more versatility, Adam, definitely.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, do you know what you could do? The Batman logo.
Yeah, you could.
Oh, so it's like glowing, like the Batman light. That'd look cool. Second coat. Good tip is, if you're not sure if you've covered everywhere, to sort of block the light out, if you hold it up to the light and see where it still looks transparent, maybe you've missed that bit or there's not quite enough gel. Because by holding it up to the light, you can kind of see where the light passes through. So now what we're going to do, this would just add like a little bit of, I mean, it looks good as it is. Obviously it needs top coat and all that, but we just want to add a little bit extra. So we've got the Snow White, and what I want to do is pull that really thin into my brush using the 0002 again. And all I'm going to do is go through the center of our shapes with the white. Don't worry about it being super opaque. We don't want it to be super opaque. It'll just add another dimension. And I'm going to cure that. Same on this one. So you're not using a lot of the gel polish, it's very fine. You can see there's not a lot on the brush. That's how we want it. Right, what I'm going to do now is go over with the top coat. This is a shiny top coat, so this will give a glossy finish. And I need a couple of coats of this just to even everything out. So I'm using this rather than the matte, because even though I'm going to actually finish with matte, but I'm using this just as a kind of a filler, I suppose.
I knew you couldn't get away without just doing matte.
No, but I just do think it'll look better in matte. But this, I feel like the shiny top coat self-levels a little bit better than a matte top coat. So it kind of fills in all the lumps and bumps because we've got layers going on here. So I'm going to do two coats of the top coat. Then I will buff it before I apply the matte top coat. And what that'll do, it'll kind of just really even the surface, which make it nice and smooth. So if you're doing any kind of nail art with layers like this, this is a good trick to do on all your kind of layered nail art, just to get everything looking a little bit smoother. So once that's cured, I'm going to take a file. This is a 240 grit file. I'm going to neaten my edges. 240 grit file won't take a lot off. But what I want to show you with the buffer is, as we file with the buffer, or buff with the buffer, you will then, it'll show up any sort of lumps and bumps. So you can see how I'm not quite catching there. So that'll just need a little bit more of a buff until it makes it smooth. We're not going to hit the design because we've got two coats of that top coat on there, creating the barrier for us. Right, so I'm going to matte top coat these now, obviously, because I just thought, you know, an obsession of mine to make everything matte. So, look how cool they look like that.
looks cool.
They're so cool. I love them. I love them. Imagine being in bed and having them. You don't need the stars on the ceiling anymore. You just need them on your nails.
Just some nails.
Because that would be so much fun. So, even like in the daytime, they look kind of cool, don't they?
Yeah.
And then in the night time, wow.
Uber cool.
Uber, definitely uber cool. There you are, guys. I hope you've enjoyed this video. Don't forget, check us out on Facebook and Instagram and all that shebang. I'll be sat here waiting for you to return and keep watching. Bye-bye.
See you later.
Speaking of kids, I can hear you one coming in the house.
Oh, have you got an Isaac?
Hello, Isaac.
He's very loud.